We broke the story. School safety may be the next to go because of budget cuts.
Putnam City has already cut bus service, and now they're looking at campus security. And Eyewitness News 5's Carla Wade is live. Carla?
Jessica, one cost-cutting option that the board has been talking about but has not voted on is reducing campus security. Now, a shooting outside of Putnam City High School a few years ago is just one reason that at least one parent we talked to says they don't think that's a good idea. Back in 2008, a gang-related shooting outside a high school basketball game forced Putnam City schools to talk about beefing up security. Now, 2 years later, a 10% reduction in state funding has the district looking at the possibility of making cuts to campus security. To save money, the district could look at reducing the number of days security or campus police officers work, or the number of officers altogether.
We may have fewer of either one of those people. Types of people. So at this point, we don't know. We just know that we can look there. Again, it's not something that affects classrooms.
But some parents are worried cost-cutting measures could eventually trickle down to the classrooms. Amanda Holliday is worried eventually teacher salaries or jobs will be cut to save money.
I want my son to get the best education he can. So if they cut the salaries for the teachers, nobody's going to go into teaching. There's not going to be future teachers for our kids to teach our kids when they get older. And that's the most important. I don't want my son to be stupid.
Her son is only 6. Even though there may be less danger of a shooting at his elementary school, she says she still worries about his safety.
I don't want somebody to come into the school and take my kid away from me. And then I'm going to have to be on the news again, wondering where my kid is, asking someone to bring my kid back home to me.
Last year, Putnam City Schools applied for a grant to help hire new officers or replace ones who were laid off. But the district did not get it. Even so, the district plans to try and reapply for that grant again for the upcoming school year. Reporting live, Carla Wade, Eyewitness News 5.